All in. They're ready. And they sent on their way. Charge ahead was slow with Wise Act, wasn't that well away. Beginning well, an American in Venice towards the inside began quickly with Hal Badia. Wise Act improves to the outside with Brotherhood of Magic, then Hat Hot Hat. They followed by Pocket Watch, who's just three lengths off the leader. Emporium's on the extreme outside of the track and racing in contention too. Further back to Lieutenant Alexander, and Storm Ahead is back towards their inside. Well, there's two groups that are split up. The outside led by Brotherhood of Magic and the inside by an American in Venice. Halberdier is up there too. Just behind them, Wise Act and Lieutenant Alexander. Pocket Watch three lengths off them. Emporium is tracking Brotherhood of Magic to the outside and got three lengths to make up. Further back in the field is Storm Ahead. Then came Hat Hot Hat, and behind that is Charge Ahead. Now they come down into the last 600 meters, and Wise Act is the leader from Lieutenant Alexander, an American in Venice. Further back in the field is Halberdier. Emporium is starting to kick home strongly towards the outside. Got three lengths to make up, though. Then came Charge Ahead, but here comes Emporium. He's coming home stoutly now with 250 left to go. Lieutenant Alexander, Emporium. Between them is Wise Act, who's fighting back in the closing stages. Wise Act hits the front from Emporium. Wise Act is going strongly for Cornet Spies. Emporium is lunging late. Here it comes. I think Wise Act held on from Emporium. A long way back to Halberdier. Then came Storm Ahead and Brotherhood of Magic. It's close. Very close indeed, but it does look on that in the slow-mo as if Emporium has gotten up to beat Wise Act in the run down to the line. Wise Act does come to take up issue with Emporium, who did hit the front about 200 meters from home. They come together in that last 100 meters to do battle. It's a matter of heads up, heads down, and I was unsure at the finish. I thought maybe Wise Act, but I think Emporium has got up to win it. So I think Emporium has won it. Let's just wait for the judges. On the slow-mo, it definitely looked like Emporium had beaten Wise Act. And I think that's going to be the case. The judges just coming through now. And Emporium has won it. The winner was number four, Emporium, for Messrs. Matthew and Anthony Capnius and apprentice Pilisand Mkoli with Paul Matchett. The winner is number four, Emporium, to Tobito, number 11, Wise Act, in the run to the line.
Hard fought, great race, and Emporium takes out race number two. Pilisand Mkoli on board for Paul Matchett. Well done to Matthew and Anthony Capnius, the son of Canford Cliffs, bred by Volkerbos Drift and Maritz Fintine. Pilisand drawn towards the outside, only one horse to follow. It was obviously always the idea to run in a straight line, but did that work out for you, just having the one horse, or would you have preferred having more around you?
You know what, I wasn't worried when I was following the one horse, because I knew that I'm following the older jockey, the jockey that is an experience, so he knew where they're going.
The best jockey?
Yes, he knew where they're going is, so I was like, it's fine. Then at the 500, I sort of pulled in, then I went straight. He went towards the outside. I knew my horse is going to fight all the way to the line.
How much heart did that horse, this horse, show there? Because it looked like Samanga had you 100 meters out. Did you think that as well?
Yeah, I also thought that. I thought maybe he got me, because his horse is a big horse and he's got a long stride, and my horse is a small horse, but he's got a big heart. But I was surprised when I came here, I saw that I won. But, you know, I think this horse still needs feather. This 1400 is a bit sharp for him. When he grows up, he's going to go like 16, 18. So. And the last time he ran behind the good horse, that horse of Mr. Tukok, and that horse is a very decent horse. So I was like, in the form, my horse has a lot of experience, so it should win you.
I'm going to ask Mr. Matchett about all the runners, because all the rest of your rides are for Paul. But if there's one that you could single out today, who would it be?
A Special Charm in the last race. I really like her. She ran a good race last time. When she ran, she needed it. But today, I think she's going to run a good race again.
Hopefully it's a good day. Well done, Pilisand.
I just want to thank Mr. Matchett for the continued support. Also, thanks to the owners. They were there in the morning. I gave them a lot of confidence. And also, thanks to the academy. Thanks to my sponsor, Stone Stamco, Mr. Eckerman.
Good job.
Thank you so much, sir.
Pilisand Mkoli, the winning jockey. Paul Matchett is the winning trainer. Thanks for the chat before the race. First and foremost, though, you turned this horse out to perfection. Well done. How happy were you with how he looked today?
Yeah, thank you, Al. I think he did look quite nice. You know, he's a narrow horse and he's immature, but he's growing taller and wider by the day. So I think in six months' time, he'll be a real beautiful-looking horse. He's already athletic type and a lovely animal. So, you know, the future looks bright for this lad. And obviously, thanks to Matthew and Anthony, you know, great supporters of my stable. And they put their cash down and they're reaping the rewards. You know, you've got to have patience in this game. And we haven't had many runners at the moment because most of the horses are babies now. You know, we sent a whole lot, a big package deal to Mauritius. So we were short of runners for them, but I said, guys, be patient. You've got nice horses, the best you've ever bought me. So the future's exciting. And like this horse, like what Phyllis Sunday said, once he goes further, he's a classic type horse. You go 2,000, 2,400, I mean, that's the type he is. He shouldn't be winning up the straight, but that's the class bringing him through.
You've answered my next question. Now, what about the rest of your day? You've got a very, very busy day ahead. Captain TikTok in the next race, so you need to go and saddle. You've got Inner Sense, Punta Alta, Explosive Bond, who improved a lot. But your last two runners really, really interest me. And if you want to talk about the others before, then feel free. Pillar Sunday obviously spoke about Special Charm. I like Back to Basics back in a 1,200 metre today. So where do you think your next best are going to come from?
Yeah, look, I think Pillar Sunday was right. Special Charm is maybe the next best, but then the horse you mentioned, Back to Basics, if he jumps, he has this habit of jumping slow, so we got to get him out the pens. If he does that today, then he's in with a shout, and the rest of them, you know, back end of quartets, you can't leave them out.
Well done, Paul.
Thank you very much. Thanks, Al.
And also, from your sponsors, going the way of the winning groom, Fanwell, that's Manuel with an F, getting the 1,500 Rand prize. How long has Fanwell been with you?
Yeah, he hasn't been here that long, and he came as an apprentice. We taught him how to look after horses. So he came from scratch, just a guy off the streets, and he looks after some nice horses now. So well done to Fanwell. He's learned the game quickly, and he looks after some good horses. And he's a lucky groom, so well done to Fanwell. And obviously, my World Sports Betting sponsors, always a great help for what they do for the game.
Nice story. Well done, Paul.
Thank you very much.
So there we go. There's the 1,500 going the way of Fanwell, who was the groom of number 4 Emporium, the son of Canford Cliffs, who wins a hard-fought contest. Second horse is good. Wise Act is going to win some races related to some well-performed horses. Put up a lovely debut here today. Pick 6 starts in race number 3, and that is due to get underway at 25-2.